We have one canceled Game of Thrones spinoff. We have one addition. Well, I guess technically two, but the other one announced is a little bit weird. And honestly, I'm excited for the two additions, although one of them should have been done as a flashback during the main time of the show, but you know, whatever. D&D just love dropping the ball. So you may remember we were told that we had six Game of Thrones spinoffs in various stages of development, and here are the ones we knew of. One about the Sea Snake, Corlys Velaryon, and his epic voyages. He may look familiar because he's in House of the Dragon, and we've already seen some promotional photos of him. Dude is a total bamf.
I would be really interested with this show if they're going to de-age the actor for having him play a younger self going on these voyages, or if they're just gonna get a new younger actor. It would be pretty interesting to see what route they go with that. But regardless, seeing the Sea Snake's voyages around the crazier parts of Essos, I think a lot of people are going to absolutely love, and I'm so happy that it's happening. There was one about Fleabottom, which I just bitched about relentlessly, but what's new? One about Nymeria and her 10,000 ships, and she eventually joins up with House Martell and helps them take over Dorne and control it as princes and princesses. One about Dunk and Egg, which I can't wait to see who they cast as Dunk because I'm just gonna horn all over him. But it focuses on Aegon V, the Unlikely, before he became a Targaryen king. And a hedge knight who travels around with him. One about House of the Dragon, which is currently filming and is about the big Targaryen civil war. And the sixth one was supposedly an animated series, but what lore it was focusing on still isn't known, though it will have animated bobs and vaginas and sex. Well, I guess the old gods and maybe the new, but the old gods are way better. We're listening to my relentless bitching because HBO has canceled the Fleabottom spinoff, and I don't even know why the slums of King's Landing they thought that was going to be a fun thing to watch. I mean, HBO, this place? I mean, maybe if you focus on the crazier times, like all the riots and tearing people apart events that happened in Fleabottom, but to just focus on the small folk, eh. Ooh, or if you were to center on some poor man traveling to Fleabottom to start a brothel and seeing it slowly become more and more successful, I would have been down for that. Thankfully, with the canceling of the Fleabottom spinoff, it wasn't really too developed. They hadn't put a lot of time and work into it. It was more of whispers of a spinoff, so it's not like we lost a lot, though maybe to you we did lose a lot by losing this, and you wanted to see more Fleabottom whorehouses. I don't know. Now, since I may have crushed your soul if you wanted the Fleabottom spinoff, let me tell you something we are getting. A Tourney of Harrenhal play. Yes, a Game of Thrones play. I'm not sure why we didn't get the Tourney of Harrenhal as a flashback in the main show. You know, Rhaegar and Lyanna, Robert Baratheon getting triggered, the whole Robert's Rebellion, the seeds for it, kind of weird, but again, D&D just but a play focused on the Tourney of Harrenhal sounds so amazing, and for some reason, it sounds more right than having it live action as a TV show or a movie. And HBO, if you give me free tickets to it, I will reduce my complaining about D&D by, I don't know, 25%. So, you know, think about that. And then send me tickets. I feel like the only way they could go wrong with this play is if they decided to make it a musical. And I'm really hoping, nothing against musicals, by the way. I like musicals just as much as the next person, but the Tourney of Harrenhal, it doesn't need to be a musical. What would be even better is if this wasn't limited and they actually contracted it out and other places could buy it and produce it. That would be really cool. And I know this also has been talked to death and people are so sick of it, but to figure out who the knight was, I know we all think it was Lyanna Stark, but to truly know who the unknown knight was, it's gonna be revealed in the play, and I'm super excited. If it's not, by the way, HBO, that's a fucking problem for me. I want to know for sure, but I think all 99% of us no, it's Lyanna Stark, and there's way too much evidence, and George has laid the groundwork for it way too well for it to be
anyone else. Now, if a play isn't your thing and you're not too excited about seeing the Tourney of Harrenhal, I know it's been talked to death. I have a million videos talking about it. Here's something else we're getting. An animated YeeT series. The land of 1,000 gods and 100 princes, ruled by one god emperor, YeeT at its height had more wealth than Valeria, had enormous armies, and was incredibly powerful. Do I wish we had an animated series focused on Sithorios? Of course, but I'm also a spoiled brat and I probably shouldn't get in my way. And I think eventually they'll give it to us. Eventually. Still, the fact that we get to see more of YeeT, we get to learn more of its lore, the fact that it's animated so they can do a lot more crazy stuff, and it's adult rated, so, you know, if you need to see some animated bobs, there you go. Also, since Corlys Velaryon did sail to YeeT, I find it interesting that we could see YeeT live action and YeeT animation, and I kind of want to compare the two and see how they do it differently. So I think with this news, I'm glad there's nothing about it that upsets me. I'm really happy they canceled the Flea Bottom spinoff. I think that was super stupid. Seeing an animated series about YeeT is going to be so cool. I can't wait to figure out what the other animated Game of Thrones spinoff is going to be. I have some ideas what it could be. It's definitely not going to be Aegon's Conquest because they already pretty much animated that whole thing. Could be Robert's Rebellion. That might be an easy way to do it, but we also have a lot of already animated videos on it, but not the complete thing. So maybe they could go there. They could do a fun thing of just focusing on a different place in Essos and Sithorios animated series. I think that would be really cool and work really well. And I never thought we would get a Game of Thrones play. I never thought that was something that would happen. And now that it is, it feels so right. But you know, let me know what you think about these spinoffs. Which ones are you excited about? Which ones do you wish just wouldn't happen? Did you really want to see the Flea Bottom one? Did that devastate you, that news? Like, subscribe, let me know in the comment section down below. And I will be releasing more Game of Thrones, The Song of Ice and Fire, sci-fi, fantasy, Witcher, Dune, so on videos. So wait for it. Not like right now, wait for it. Like, don't just sit staring at my channel waiting for me to upload it. Go live your life, but subscribe and you'll see them when they come in.